Hello viewers, welcome back again to our CRE class. The topic of discussion today is Prophet Amos, and we get to look at the teachings of Prophet Amos. Remember, previously in our previous class, we did look at the visions of Prophet Amos, but now today we get to look at what are some of the teachings of Prophet Amos. Of Prophet Amos. Straight to our discussion, the first teaching of Prophet Amos was lack of social justice. Remember, when we did introduce the background call of Prophet Amos, we said during that time, Israel was in a harm of, there was no social justice, right? In this case here, people were not treated fairly. Good? There was no concern. People not show concern to the needs of others. For example, the rich did not show concern to the poor, right? There was no justice in the courts of law. Good. Now, there is why Amos thought of the social justice, right, as a teaching. So there was lack of social justice. Good. And I've told you this, that it implied that people did not show the needs of others. Good. Can you get to see that? People are yearning for justice. They are saying justice now, right? Let justice roll down. A study of the book of Amos. So basically in Israel, Amos is a prophet thought of social justice. Good. And again, practice of hypocritical religion in Israel, right? There was hypocritical religion. What does that mean? That there was insincere worship, right? The people did not worship God with sincerity. Right? They made empty sacrifices. They worshiped God alongside other gods, right? So they worshiped idols as well as God. They made idols, for example, of Baal, and also offered sacrifices to them. Good, you can see that. They're offering worship. They're offering sacrifices to the idol God, who was Baal, right? Another teaching of Prophet Amos is oppression of the poor by the rich in Israel. The poor were highly oppressed. Let us get to look at how were the poor oppressed in Israel, right? How were the poor oppressed? Now, officials sold the righteous for silver and the needy for a pair of sandals. Look at that. The righteous were sold for silver and the needy or the poor were just sold for a pair of sandals or shoes. This was like slavery in Israel. Good. The rich also trampled on the poor, despised them, and placed no value on the poor. Right? They were just stepped on. Right? They were oppressed by the rich. The poor also gave their garments as security of loan. If you want to get a loan, remember garments were highly valued. Right? If you want to get a loan from someone, you could just give your garment as a security. Remember, a garment was very rare. Right? In Israel at that time, it was very precious. Now, for you to get a loan, you have to deposit your garment as a security. The Samaritan women were also fat, like well-fed cows of Bashan, right? They led luxurious lives and were very unkind to the poor. Look at that. The Samaritan women were fat. What does that tell us, right? They did not care of the poor, right? They did not get care of the poor. Look at that. Look at that. Look how that one is full to satisfaction, right? Fat like the cows of Bashan, what Amos is telling us. Good, right? Let's look at another teaching was corruption and bribery. Now the churches, the judges in the courts were corrupt. They accepted bribes, right? They accepted bribes. There was a conspiracy between the rich and the judges against the poor. Right, there was conspiracy in the courts, meaning the poor did not get justice in the law, in the courts of law. Then there was pride in material possessions. The Israelites prided themselves in their riches and material possessions. Amos told them God will destroy their wealth. Right, pride in material possessions. Let's look at another teaching: dishonesty. The wealth merchants waited impatiently for end of the holidays so that they could engage in lucrative business. How were the business lucrative? How were these businesses lucrative? They cheated the poor by using false scales, right? They cheated the poor by using false scales. They sold bad wheat to the poor, right? They mixed the good wheat and the bad grains and sold them to the poor. Look at that, how people were dishonest during the teachings of Amos. There's also sexual immorality, right? Where there was temple prostitution or cultic prostitution, right? For another example of sexual immorality, a father and son could have sex with the same girl, right? That was Israel. That's what some of the teachings of Prophet Amos. Sexual immorality, where a father and a son could have sex with the same girl, right? There was also drunkenness. Talk of hypocritical religion and idolatry in Israel, right? Whereby Israelites did a lot of religious rites according to the laws of Moses, and yet a majority of them were unjust, corrupt, and also oppressed the poor. Look at that, hypocritical religion, right? On the Sabbath day, they are very holy, observing all the commandments, right? But on these other days, they are oppressing the poor, very unjust, corrupt. Good. Empty sacrifices, what are they? This is another way of insincere worship, right? You are giving your offerings and sacrifices to God. But again, inwardly, these sacrifices were not free, right? They were just mere sacrifices, an offshore. It was an offshore kind of sacrifice. You are just showing God that you are giving a sacrifice. But what you are doing is not right. Talk of sexual morality, right? Talk of insincere worship, all those. Empty sacrifice. Look at that. The empty sacrifice the Israelites could give. Look at that person now. Right? He seems to be holy, giving a sacrifice. But in essence, those were just empty sacrifices. Now, class, for assignment, can we get to state how the poor were oppressed in Israel? And as always, your reference is Calbi, right? The Secondary Christian Religious Education Student's Book, the 3rd edition. And as always, this is Elim TV, your favorite learning channel, where you get to watch and learn.